In this video, we introduce and define I, we define and simplify square roots of negative numbers, the standard form of a complex number, and define the real and imaginary parts. So far, we've worked with the real number line, where any point on this number line was called a real number. So we had like 0, 1 half, pi, negative 9, square root of 5. Those are some examples of some real numbers. It could be positive, negative, 0, rational, or irrational. But square root of negative 9 is not a real number. Square root of negative 9 is not on the real number line. Because when you square a real number, it has to be positive. So the problem is here, when you're figuring out what's the square root of negative 9, you're trying to find some number, let's say I don't know what it is, I'll call it x. What number squared is going to equal negative 9? And there's a problem. Any number that's real, when you square it, will not be negative. So the complex numbers were formed, and that's what we're going to go over now. What's the first thing we have to know about complex numbers is that there's an imaginary unit called I. All right, what does I mean? I is the number square root of negative 1. This is the definition, which means that I squared equals negative 1. So, wow, now there is some number that when you square it, it's equal to a negative number. So this is the definition of I. They both really mean the same thing. So I is the square root of negative 1. It's a number. It's not a variable. It's problematic that we happen to call it imaginary because that sounds like it doesn't exist, but it does exist. It's an actual number. It's not a real number. It's a complex number. So now we're back to, well, what is square root of negative 9? Can we simplify that? And as it turns out, we never leave a negative under the square root sign. So a square root of a negative number is not in simplest form. So we don't want to leave a square root of a negative number. So we're going to go back to our definition here. I equals the square root of negative 1. We could have left things as square root of negative 1, but I looks more simplified. So we're going to use this idea that square root of negative 1 is just I. So now we're going to take the square root of negative 9. And what we could do is think of that as the square root of 9 times negative 1, okay? Which is the square root of 9 times the square root of negative 1, or 3 I. So the square root of negative 9 is actually the imaginary number 3i. When you have a number times I, it's called a pure imaginary number. Okay? They're all complex numbers, but if there's just a number times I or just I itself, it's called a pure imaginary number. So in general, this is the rule we need to use. So, since the square root of a negative number is not in simplest form, we need to rewrite numbers like this. Square root of if b is greater than 0, okay, then the square root of negative b would be the square root of a negative number, correct? Like negative 16, negative 9, is written as the square root of b times I. So let's look at that square root of negative 9. The shortcut is, if you have the square root of a negative number, it's the square root of the positive part times I. And that's how we deal with negative numbers under the square root. So the square root of negative 9 then would be 3i. So we're going to be using this definition. Here we go. To to simplify some square roots of negative numbers. So put the video on pause and try these two problems. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is write that as square root of 25i, and then the square root of 25 is 5, so we have 5i. Now be careful that you don't extend this square root sign over the I. Then that's even more complicated, because then you'd be taking the square root of 25i. It's not what we want. It's just the square root of 25 times I. Alright, square root of 18i for this second one. Now, square root of 18, I simplify it this way. That's 9 times 2. I could take the square root of 9 out as a 3, so I get 3 square roots of 2. I. You will see people do this. A lot of times the I is written in front of the square root so they don't accidentally extend it. So 3i square roots of 2 means the same thing as 3 square roots of 2 times I. You just have to be comfortable seeing it either way. I'm usually just very careful and leave a little space before that I so that my square root symbol is not over the I. So these two numbers, square root of negative 25 and square root of negative 18, written in their simplest form, is either 5i for square root of negative 25, or 3 square roots of 2i, or 3i square roots of 2 for the square root of negative 18. And these are both pure imaginary numbers. So any number in the form bi, where b is a real number, is a pure imaginary number. Okay, so we've got the basics that, you know, I is the basic unit. It's called the basic imaginary number. Some people call it the imaginary unit. And then we've got some other numbers which are pure imaginary numbers, like 3i, negative square root of 5i, pi I, anything where you just have something times I, but the number in front of it is a real number, then these are called the pure imaginary numbers. Negative I, 1/2 I, etc. The complex numbers include all the numbers, the real numbers, like negative 3, 0, 1, pi, square root of 7, 3 fourths. In other words, it could be 0, it could be negative, it could be positive, it could be a complex number, it could be a rational number, it could be an irrational number like square root of 7 or pi, it could be a rational number like 3 fourths, etc. The pure imaginary numbers are any real number times I, like 5i, negative I, square root of 2i, and any number that can be written in the form a plus bi is called a complex number. So something like 3 minus 5i, 1/2 plus square root of 3i, 7, negative 9i. Now you might say, wait a minute, 7, that's not written as a plus bi, but you can do it because you could write that as 7 plus 0i. So I'm saying if you could write it in that form, then it's a complex number. And how would we do it for this negative 9i? We could write that as 0 minus 9i. So a complex number can be written in the form a plus bi. A is the real part, b is the imaginary part. A complex number written as a plus bi is said to be in standard form. A is called the real part and b is called the imaginary part. So state the real part and imaginary part of each of the four complex numbers I have here. Put the video on pause and try those on your own. Now what you could do is put those in standard form if you need to first, so it's easy to identify A and B. In the first one, A, the real part is 7, and the imaginary part is the negative 4. It's the coefficient of I. Now for this second one, notice you don't see an I anywhere, so you could think of this as 0i. So the real part is square root of 5, and the imaginary part is 0. For the third one, you have an I, but you don't have just a real part. So this could be thought of as 0 plus 1i. So the real part is 0, and the imaginary part is 1. And for the last one, we did this at the beginning of the video. Remember, that's the square root of 9i, which is 3i, which could be written as 0 plus 3i. So here's another one where the real part is 0 and the imaginary part is 3.